Okay, it's Dave here. I got this Sunitron moving LED sign display board here. I got to fix, and this chip here is shorted. It gets very hot when the unit is running, so I'm just going to show you how to quickly remove a chip like this without having to desolder all the pins. Okay, so you want to take a pair of nice cutters like this and just go right along the edge here, like so, and just clip each lead. Now, of course, you wouldn't want to do this if you didn't know the chip itself was defective. I know that this is defective, this chip, because it gets very hot. So you take a good pair of cutters, side cutters, you go along here right at the edge of this chip where the pin connects into the die or the package. And just snip it. I'm going to try and get a little better light on the situation here for you. But now I'll try and do this with my left hand. Best just to turn it around. So you just go along here and snip all the pins. Going to zoom in a little more here for the last couple ones here so you can really see this well. Now you want to make sure they're all clipped well. So I see some on the other side here aren't quite all the way through. Just check them all to make sure. So, there must be a couple on this side that aren't all the way through. So just check them all. Okay, so we got the bad chip out of there. Okay, so now, the trick to getting the pins out without having to desolder them is you got to have a good Weller soldering iron, okay? And then what you do is you just apply a little bit of solder to the tip and lift the pin out. See that? Okay, and then get rid of it. Apply the solder, lift, and the pin comes right out. Now the reason why the soldering iron, you need a Weller soldering iron, is because they're magnetically temperature controlled with a magnet, so the tip is actually magnetic, so things that are made of metal stick to it. So you don't need to pull or pry or anything like that. The pins will just pop right out. Now I can do usually a bunch of these at the same time, more than one pin, but I like to do just one at a time. Then when you're done, you can just use a soldering iron or a desoldering tool to clean the holes out. Pin one was at the top here. Now you don't want to throw these pins on the floor, because if you're ever in your sock feet, you will get one of these pins in your foot, and they don't they aren't very nice. They're like little shards of glass. They're very sharp, very pointed. They go right into your skin very easily. So now, when I replace this chip, I'm going to put a socket in here, because this is a common problem on these. The communications chip gets fried out when lightning strikes. So by putting a socket in, I will be able to change this next time without having to desolder the chip. So I've got a socket handy here. So there, I got all the pins out without destroying any traces, as you can see. Very clean. So now I'll flip it over and I will desolder all the holes now. But first, I'm going to just apply a little bit of solder to each one to get it to come out very easily. Okay, so now I take my desoldering tool, okay, pump it up, and then just start desoldering the holes. It's a lot easier than trying to desolder all the pins and then get the chip out without pulling any plating holes out. So this works much better and it's a lot quicker. Now you can do the same thing with any dip chip, whether it be 40 pin or 20 pin or 18 pin, 16 pin, 14 pin, 8 pin, even a quad dip 64 will come out very easily. Just the last thing you want to do is wreck one of the holes, because when they're double-sided boards like this, the hole has to be plated through for it to make the connection to the other side. That's not always the case, but sometimes that's the case. So it And you don't want to overheat the pad too much. This is a 700 degree tip chisel point. Okay, and there she's all done, all desoldered, all the holes. Now what I want to do is take a socketed chip, or a socket, a 40 pin socket, just set it in the holes like that, flip it over. Of course I'm going to solder two of the corners just to make sure that it's held in there correctly first. So I get some solder on my iron and then just touch it to one of the holes. You want to make sure that the socket is in there nice and flat up against the circuit board, like so. Okay. And then what you want to do is re-solder all those pins. You also want to make sure that pin number one of the socket is in the right spot as well, so there's no ifs, ands, or buts as to where or which end of the chip socket is pin one. I'm trying carefully not to damage that wire wrap wire, because if I melt a hole in the side of the insulation on it, it will end up shorting out to one of the pins. Okay. So there you have it. I have the socket soldered back in again. Now all I have to do is place the chip, the new chip, into the socket and we'll be all set. Just gotta go get that, as I forgot to bring it with me. It's sitting over here on the table. So, it's a static sensitive device, so you want to be careful when you're handling it. And here it is here, brand new one, just pop it out of the case here. Now, in order to get it in the socket very easily, what I do is just give it a little bend like this. So you bend the pins in a little, because they come spread quite widely apart. And then place it in the socket like so, and push down. Okay, so there's the old one. They got the both the exact same part numbers. So this board should be ready and all fixed up. Thanks for watching this little demonstration.